Hello, my name is Lindsay Fuhrer, and that is Becca Cagley. I worked with Becca, and we have attended St. Michael's for 9 years together, and we've always wished for a nice play area. We have had an asphalt lot since we were little, and have always wanted this nice, clean, perfect playground. We imagined what we wanted when we were children, and what other children we wanted. Other children would want. We put a slide, seesaw, swing sets, picnic table, sitting area, and sandbox. We have to keep in mind our budget. Our budget is $10,000, and we hope to stay in that age range. To save money, we can have things donated and build things ourselves. Our materials. Our picnic tables are wooden or plastic square tables that range from $100 to $500 at home improvement stores. Our sitting area. Our sitting area is used with large logs and shredded tire turf, which is also eco-friendly, recycled, but not all inexpensive. Our mosaic tiles. They are made of square and circle stepping stones with broken glass and St. Michael's Children's Hands prints made by their art club. Swing sets. We have metal frame swing sets with plastic seats. For two seats, it would range about $1,000, and for four seats, it would range to about $2,000. The slide is sturdy, safe plastic that was freestanding and 38 inches. That would range from about $2,000 to $3,000 from detailed play pro. Our seesaws are wooden seesaws, and for four seats, it would cost about $800. Our sandbox is the wood plank boards around with the sand in the middle, of course. For a 6x6, it would cost about $900, and for a 10x10, it would cost about $1,000.
We place everything in our playground there for a reason. We put a fence around our area because we have a busy highway right next to it, so we wouldn't want kids running out in front of the street or even in our parking lot. We place mosaic tile entrance so that we can show personality and show that our school is fun and our art club could help with that. We place the sitting area there so we could relax and talk on some days when you just don't want to play around and you could talk to your friends. We place the swing sets there because what's a playground without a swing set or a slide? And all kids all ages will enjoy a swing set and slide. We also place the sandbox there because we thought preschool would really enjoy playing in the sand on nice days that have weather, that have really good weather, and the preschool will really enjoy that.
Building. First, we would need to correct all the land problems and fix the concrete sidewalk in front near the highway. Then, we would need to get everything built and installed before we would put the fence around. Then, we would need to correct all the problems that caused by the trucks and movers getting the play sets onto the land. The fence could be placed and then it would be a normal picket fence, or we could be creative and have a plexiglass fence that kids can draw on with whiteboard markers. Another thing we need to put in consideration is the moving cost. The moving cost would have an amount, so we would need to put that in our budget also. Reasons. Each item has a reason for being placed there. First, the sandbox. The sandbox in our playground is for multiple ages and can be used for digging and building and for creativity. Swing sets. We have swing sets because they can be used to just sit out, swing, and you would feel like you are flying. A slide. A slide in our playground is because it is a classic, and many kids have visited other playgrounds and love the slides. Our seesaws. We chose seesaws because it's something you can do with a friend, and it is very active and just fun to do. Our picnic tables. We put picnic tables on our lot because it is somewhere where the older kids could sit, eat lunch, and talk, as well as the sitting area. The mosaic tile entrance. We chose to put this in our playground because it is bright, fun, and shows the creativeness of our St. Michael students.
The age range we are shooting for is all the way from preschool all the way up to eighth grade, and everything we have in our playground is for that age range, and everybody shoots. Everything, and there's nothing that one person can't use and one person can't. This concludes our presentation. Thank you for listening, and we hope you consider some of our ideas.